Good morning, dear students. So, this part consists the external female genitalia. The female genitalia consists of mons pubis, two labia majora, two labia minora, the vestibule, the bulb of the vestibule, this much consists of the external female genitalia. The whole thing altogether, this is called the vulva or pudendum. Now I am describing one by one. The first one is the mons pubis. It is the subcutaneous elevation over the symphysis pubis, pubic tubercle and superior pubic ramus. Below the mons pubis, the subcutaneous fat lies. Here, after puberty, the coarse and crisp hairs appear, and more or less the level of the hair line, it is horizontal in case of female. Now coming to the next part, that is the labia majora. The mons pubis inferiorly, it is continuous with the two cutaneous fold, that is called the labia majora. The labia majora, anteriorly they are connected by the anterior commissure, posteriorly they are connected by the posterior commissure. The labia majora is the thick skin fold. Below the labia majora lies the subcutaneous fat, sebaceous gland, apocrine gland and sweat gland. It is dark in pigmentation, but on medial aspect it is more or less pink in color. Now in the upper part of the labia majora, the distal part of the round ligament of the uterus lies or merge with the subcutaneous fat. Now coming to the next part, that is the labia minora. Labia minora, thin skin fold which is fatless, and between the two labia minora the space lies which is called the vestibule. The vestibule receives the opening of the external urethral orifice and the external vaginal orifice, and the vestibule, it is covered by one fibrous membrane that is called the hymen, and it has got opening in variable distance. So between the hymen and the labia minora, the opening of the greater and lesser bulbovestibular gland present. Anteriorly, the two labia minora fold, they splits over one prolongation or elongation, that is called the clitoris. The superior layer, it unites with the corresponding superior layer, they form the prepuce of the clitoris. The inferior layer, they unite, they form the frenulum of the clitoris. The clitoris, the third point is the clitoris. Clitoris is present at the anterior end of the two-fold labia minora, it has got glands or teeth, then body and the root. The glands is the free end, and the body, it has got the erectile tissue called the corpora cavernosa, and on corpora cavernosa on the both side they are attached with the pubic arch. Below the labia minora on both the side lies the another erectile tissue that is called the bulb of the vestibule. The bulb of the vestibule, they are continuous with the glands or tip of the clitoris, and they are invested by the bulbous spongiosus muscle. Now, the posteriorly the two skin fold labia minora, they unite and they form the frenulum of the posterior frenulum of the minora. That is called also fossae. The two labia majora, they unite posteriorly at the posterior commissure, and this area lies, the area lies between the anal orifice and the posterior commissure, that is 2.5 cm to 3 cm anterior, that is the gynecological perineum. Now coming to the vestibule. Vestibule is the space between the two lips of the labia minora, and it has got the opening of the urethral orifice and the vaginal orifice. Urethral orifice lies 2 cm below the glans penis, glans clitoris. Now I will show it the different parts in the specimen. Come.
So this is the specimen showing the different features of the external female genitalia. Now this area is called the mons pubis. It is the subcutaneous eminence which lies on the pubic symphysis, pubic tubercle and the superior ramus of the pubis. Here lies the coarse hair during the puberty. The hairs, the line of the hairs, more or less horizontal hair. In case of male, it extends up to umbilicus. Inferiorly, the mons pubis, it extends as the labia majora, to labia majora. It is dark pigmented, but medially it is pinkish in shape, and it contains subcutaneous fat, then sweat gland, and apocrine gland, and the anteriorly it is united, forms the anterior commissure. Posteriorly it is united, forms the posterior commissure. Between the anal orifice and the posterior commissure lies the gynecological perineum. In the upper part of the subcutaneous tissue of the labia majora, the round ligament of the uterus submerge here. Okay. Now coming to the, and this the cleft which lies between these two, that is the pudendal cleft. Now coming to the second part. This is the thin skin without the subcutaneous subcutaneous fat, the skin fold, that is called the labia minora. Between the two labia minora lies the, this is the vestibule of the vagina. This area is called the vestibule of the vagina. So this is the pudendal cleft and this is the vestibule of the vagina. The vestibule of the vagina receives the orifice of the urethral orifice and the vaginal orifice. And between the skin fold of the labia minora and the membrane, fibrous membrane with opening, lies, that is the hymen. The opening of the, on the side of the vaginal orifice, the opening of the greater and lesser vestibular gland or Bartholin gland present. Now the third part is the clitoris. Clitoris, it has got glands, then body and the root. The skin fold of the labia minora at the anterior end, they splits over, and the superior layer, they unite with the corresponding layer, they forms the prepuce of the clitoris. This is the prepuce of the clitoris. And the inferior layer, they unite, they form the frenulum of the clitoris. So clitoris has got the tip, body and the root, and the prepuce or hood of the clitoris. Okay. And the body of the clitoris has got the most erectile tissue, that is the corpora cavernosa. It is continuous as the, and attached with the superior pubic arch, forms the crura of the clitoris. Crura of the clitoris. Now, this is the vestibular area, the vestibule of the vagina, and it has got urethral orifice, vaginal orifice, urethral orifice, and this is the here lies the rupture during repetitive vaginal delivery. The hymen ruptures and becomes caruncle, and it presents the margin of the vagina, it is irregular, whereas the margin of the urethra, it is regular one, and it is more closer to the clitoris. Now the gynecological perineum, here this is the anal opening, and here lies the 2.5 to 3 cm lies in front of the anal opening, that is the gynecological perineum. Now the corresponding different part of the female genitalia in comparison with the male, that is the labia majora, they developed from the genital swelling, and in case of male, they fuse together, they forms the scrotum. But in case of female, it is deviated here. Not they are not fused here. So this is the labia majora, and when they fuse, they form the scrotum in the male genital part. The clitoris, it develops from the genital tubercle, and it corresponds with the penis of the male. But the difference between these two is the, it is not traversed by the urethra, but in case of penis, it is traversed by the urethra. In case of female, the urethra is 4 cm length and it opens into the vestibule more closer to the clitoris. So, the opening of the urethra or urethral orifice present in the vestibule area. Not it is present in the body of the clitoris. But in case of male, it is the urethra traversed within the penis. Another thing is the labia minora. It is developed from the genital fold. And in case of male, it is the penile urethra. So, labia majora is the developed from the genital swelling. In case of male, it corresponds with the scrotal swelling. In case of female, it is deviated, not united. The clitoris, it corresponds to the penis of the male. And it is not traversed but the urethral orifice. The labia minora, these two are deviated here and they forms in case of male the penile urethra. So with this we can conclude the different features of the external female genitalia. I have explained in the previous video that during the vaginal examination, we can put the different digits, mostly the index and the middle finger through the vagina, we can assess through this examination, we can assess the space or length of the different pelvic diameter, and we can also palpate the different pelvic visceral condition through this digital examination. During delivery, the posterior lateral aspect of this labia majora, the incision is put, the procedure is called the episiotomy. With this incision, we can increase the passage or increase the opening of the butt canal, and this procedure is known as the episiotomy. Later on, you will come into acquaintance with this orifice procedure. Is the urethral orifice, and this orifice is the vaginal orifice. Urethral orifice is closer to the clitoris. And vaginal orifice is more posteriorly. So, this is anterior orifice, urethral orifice, and this is the more posterior orifice. Okay, this is the more posterior orifice. And this is the prepuce of the clitoris. And this tip is the, free tip is the glans of the clitoris. So, glans of the clitoris, prepuce of the clitoris, urethral orifice, these two are the labia minora, this area is called the vestibule, and this is the pudendal cleft, this much is the pudendal cleft, and this area is the fossae or posterior commissure of the labia minora, the fossae. Okay, so this area is the gynecological perineum, this area is the gynecological perineum. Gynecological perineum, fossae, and these two are the labia minora, this is the vestibule, this is the prepuce of the clitoris, and this is the glans of the clitoris. Glans of the clitoris, prepuce of the clitoris, and this is the body of the clitoris. Anterior commissure, posterior commissure, this is the medial aspect of the two labia majora.